Hi, Carl Schuckert here with FinalExpenseProgram.com, your leading authority for final expense sales education. This is here, we're gonna be talking about 14 things that must happen every day while you're in the field. So I'm just gonna go through these things one by one. Let's talk about the first one. The first one is you need to map out all your leads. If you do not own our CRM app, then this is something you must do. And part of that is you need to do a minimum, not a maximum, but a minimum of 10 to 15 drop bys every single day. You need to somehow fit that into your equation. Unless you did 5 presentations, and that's understandable, but these are minimum numbers. And in fact, I used to go out and do 30. So for someone to commit to 10 or 15, that should not be a problem at all. The next thing is to be clean and dress for success. Obviously, you don't wanna look ratty, you wanna smell good. I've talked about this before, but just make sure you're dressed for success. People don't wanna buy something from someone that looks like a bum. 3, knock with confidence. Knock up on the door jamb, knock hard, confidence, and then step back. The 4th thing, smile. Have fun. You want to make sure you're having fun while you're out in the field. Always, number 5 is always, always, always get to the kitchen table. Even if you have to move stuff off of their table, it doesn't matter. You need to get to the table. That's where people do business. There are going to be some situations where, you know what, it's just not going to happen. You have to do it. You have to improvise. I've done it on hoods of cars before, but typically you want to make sure that you get to that table. Number 6 is never present to one-leggers, meaning the other spouse is not home, unless there's no way to do it. And again, use your best judgment. This here again is just one of those things that you want to absolutely do, because typically you're going to be wasting your time. And I could promise you that 9 out of 10 times you will be wasting your time if you pitch the spouse. So make sure that they're both home. If they're not, reschedule. And even if you're worried about, oh, I'm not gonna get in front of this person again, it doesn't matter, because you're gonna present to that person, and then that person's gonna say, oh, I need to talk to my wife. Even if you said, do you need your wife here to make a decision? See, a lot of people are trained to know that, and they'll say, no, I can make my own decision. Can you make your own decision? Yeah, I can make my own decision. And then you get to the question, and it's like, can you make your own decision? You know, that's kind of a big decision. I need my wife to be here. Well, we already knew why they filled out the card, so. Again, just make sure the spouse is there. And sometimes spouses don't even want to be there. And sometimes when you're there, the spouse will blow the deal. But I'll tell you this, you might pitch them and then they'll go, and then you'll be calling them back, and then they'll be calling their spouse, and their spouse will totally blow it, because they'll only remember half the information, maybe only even a quarter of what you told them. And like I would keep saying is, it's a ramp. The sale is a ramp. And it's a buildup. They gotta get to know you and like you and trust you, like we've been saying, to go all the way up and then make the sell. When it feels right, when it seems right, when it sounds right, you know, that's powerful. So keep that in mind, that you wanna make sure that they're both there. Number 7 is always hold your pen only when you write. Never hold the pen when you are not writing. The powerful pen is a weapon of distraction. Number 8, always congratulate your clients often and make them feel good about wanting to get this taken care of. Throughout the presentations, we say congratulations. We can tell that you care. I mean, constantly we're saying good things. It's also a good idea to continue to say nice things about someone else. I mean, heck, who doesn't like to hear good things? When people give me compliments, makes me feel all warmy and fuzzy inside. Make your clients feel warm and fuzzy inside. Number 9. Always ask questions that get a yes, like, doesn't that make sense? Pretty nice, huh? Isn't it nice to finally have this, finally get this taken care of? Is that fair? They can't say no when you use words like these, right? See, I just got you to say yes. Always present the whole presentation to the closing question, even if the client is rushing you. People think they know everything, especially the ones that'll rush you. Now, these people, it's okay to slow down. They might sound or seem like they're frustrated or whatever, okay? It doesn't matter. You're in control. You need to keep control. Also, pay attention to the NLP strategies that we teach in our next level training. Make sure you understand that so that way you can communicate better with these people. But the people that are rushing you, it's because they know they're gonna be sold something and they know that they're buyers. And the other thing is, if you rush over everything, you're not gonna be in that ramp where you're getting people to know, like, and trust you. You're not gonna get people receptive when they're supposed to be receptive. You're not going to get people to understand. And then even if they do buy, there's a good chance that they're going to cancel it because they don't understand the importance of it. So again, just make sure that you actually use the presentation. A lot of times what I'll say is, you're on page 7 or 11. I'm still only on page 4 or 5. And just say that. Just say, I'm getting there. I promise. Our company requires us to say this. I know some of these things aren't fun to talk about, but think about this. This is the last time you're gonna have to think or worry or anything about it, because we're just gonna make sure you get it taken care of, and then you never have to, out of sight, out of mind, never have to think about it again. Number 11 is, never slide and turn your presentation binder so that your client can see it. I recently talked to a new guy that's in our next level training, and he said that it was really hard for him to see, and then I had to figure it out. Well, what was happening is that he was turning the presentation binder around and trying to read it from upside down. Never do that, okay? Just, I know it seems like, yeah, it seems like that makes sense, because when you're looking at a presentation, everyone can read the presentation. Keep it in front of you. You're in control. Being that you're in control, if you do this, they will be in control. Okay, if you slide it around and you show it to them, guess who's gonna be in control? They're the ones that are gonna be in control, right? And that's same with showing numbers, all that stuff. It's all facing you. Trust me, they can see it, all right? Always be assumptive when collecting referrals and closing the sale, all right? What I mean by that is, assume that everyone buys, regardless of what happened at the last presentation. You see, what happens is we wear this backpack of emotions, all right? And every time someone says no, we throw a boulder into the backpack, right? No, boulder into a backpack, boulder into a backpack. But really, you need to change that little mental thinking there to make you think that, huh, got that one out of the way, I don't have to worry about it. But what happens in all actuality, especially for the kinesthetic people, the emotional people, we carry that with them, and all of a sudden that weight just gets heavy and it's hard to lift, right? And so you're walking into those homes with that on your back, but guess what? That's a brand new opportunity. You need to treat that opportunity as if it was your last opportunity, and you need to give your best presentation you've ever given in your life. I mean, you just need to think the cameras are rolling and you are ready to rock and roll because you've studied your presentation. You've done all the preparation, the perfect preparation to have that perfect sell, and you're just ready to rock and roll every single time. And what will happen is momentum will pick up, and momentum is one of the biggest keys in sales. You see, people take themselves out of the field. I don't get it. When you get momentum rolling, what happens is you get into the grooves of success. And once you're rolling in those grooves of success, it's easy to get out if you stop working. But if you stay in there, you're gonna be extremely successful, and you wanna just ride that baby out. You wanna ride that thing out as hard as you can, all right? Now, number 13 is always cement every sell. Make sure you have your clients write on the option sheet why this is important. It's the last thing you do. That is the first thing that they remember. So when you leave, you want them to remember why they own it. You know, end or start and end with why. Why you own it. So when you leave and they look at their folder, they're gonna look at their folder and they're gonna say, why do I have this? Why is this $57 or $110 coming out of my check every single month, or my checking account? And they're gonna forget about it. People forget, but then they'll think about, what was the last thing? Oh, the last thing is I wanted to protect my family, blah, blah, blah. And if they do forget it, it's gonna be written in there. And they're gonna see it with their eyes, and they're gonna be able to say, that's why. And they'll have that comfort, that peace of mind. All of those things will come back. All those memories will come back. They'll reinforce the reason why they have it in the first place. And number 14 is to stick. This is the last one, and I hope you remember it to the best, okay? Stick to your word, even if you have to go out of your way to do it. It's so important. It's so vitally important that you're not flaky with your clients. And be careful. I mean, if you don't feel comfortable with doing something, just tell them. Be honest and be genuinely who you are. But when you do, if you do make a promise, you want to make sure you go out of your way and you do it over and above. You give. Givers gain. You see, the more you give out, the more will come back. Something stuck in my eye. So givers gain. The more you give out, the more you will get back. I promise you this. Okay, guys, that's the 14 things that must happen every single day during your presentation. I just wanted to put this together as the finalizing step to the presentation and all the training that goes with the presentation. And then the next step is we're going to be talking more about the next level stuff. So we'll see you there. This is Carl Schuchert, FinalExpenseProgram.com, Next Level Training. And I'm very grateful to have you guys here. Thank you so much for being a part of this. If you have any questions, use this form. It's private. It's between us peers only. All right? Thanks. Have a great day.